Hey everybody, welcome back to Mad Horse Barbecue. My name is Brian, if you hadn't guessed it already. And in this video, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a full turkey on my Gateway drum smoker. And if you watched my last turkey video, I did say what I was gonna do with this one in the last video. But we're gonna do an overnight brine on it, and then we're also gonna do an injection on it. You see this 5-gallon Ace Hardware pail. This, let me add it, it is a clean Ace Hardware pail. The only thing this has ever been used for is water. I had a competition about a month or so ago. It was on a parking lot. We got probably 2 to 3 inches of rain that night, about 40, 50 mile an hour winds, and 6 of these buckets full of water made sure my tent didn't go anywhere. But this is gonna be turned into my brine bucket. I already got the brine made up. What I got in here is 2.5 gallons of water to 2 bags of this Oak Ridge Barbecue Game Changer. What I did do is I took 2.5 cups out of it and put it into a jar after I got done mixing it up, because I am gonna brine this, or sorry, I am gonna inject this as well. But you know, the best thing to use, one of the easiest things to use for brining a large bird would be a 5-gallon pail, a clean 5-gallon pail. You can get the, you know, like the Pyrex, you know, plastic containers too. But this is what I got. I don't have anything else that would have worked, I don't think. But super simple. Start tonight's cook. I got a spot open up in the fridge for a 5-gallon pail. So all we're gonna do tonight is we're gonna get this cut out of the package. We're gonna get it put into brine. So let's go ahead and do that real quick. This supposedly is a cryovac grip and tear. I don't know. That made this easy. Open the bag, insert one finger in each of the hand holes and even force, pull one to the right, the other to the left until the bag starts opening. So let's go ahead and try that. Oh, there we go. That worked out pretty good. Okay, now that it's out, I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm gonna pat it dry. It doesn't make much sense why I'm doing this, but I'm just gonna do it anyways. Move my bucket over. This is already all mixed up nice. So I'm just gonna go ahead and take the turkey. I'm gonna put it in breast side down, right in the brine. Okay, just like that. So this is gonna go ahead and sit in my fridge. It is getting kind of close here in southern Minnesota right now to be able to leave this out in the garage, but it's still like 50 degrees right now. And I'm not cool with leaving it out in 50 degree weather, even though I'm sure it'll just be fine, but I'm gonna go ahead and throw this in the fridge overnight, and we will pick back up tomorrow afternoon when we're pulling this out of the brine. So we'll see you then. All right, well, this turkey has been in a brine for 20 hours now, so let's go ahead and get it out, get it patted dry, and get it injected. That'll be good. Let's go ahead and get it injected now. I'm only gonna inject the breast meat, because I think that the thighs and the wings in the drumsticks, they say plenty good, so I'm just gonna do the breast. This is just one of the cheap butcher block injectors. These are my favorite ones, just because super easy to clean, and I think they work relatively good for what they are. I do have some of the spring-loaded ones, and those are nice, but it's time-consuming to clean those ones, I think. Just gonna go ahead and probably gonna do about 2 full injectors into each breast, so go ahead and do that. Okay, that'll be good on the injection. All right, now since it's injected, what I'm gonna go ahead and do is rub this thing down. We're gonna use 2 rubs today. First rub we're gonna use is the Tailgater Barbecue Party Rub. Party turkey, I love party rub, so it's a good rub pretty much on anything. I especially like it on poultry, so we're gonna put it on there. And then we're also gonna use the Heavy Smoke White Label as well. So what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna get the back side of it, and then since I'm gonna be cooking on this rack, I don't have to handle the bird after I get the back side seasoned and put it back over. So let's go ahead and season the back side up first. Party rub first. Put number 1 with the white label. Over. Tuck the wings first and don't go do that. Kind of just pull the wing, and just pull it up front, and then tuck it right underneath the bird, just like this. Right underneath the breast, I should say. Just like that. Tuck this wing too, same way. Take the tip right to the breast, or right underneath the breast. Just like that. Get this thing positioned how I want it on here. Now we're gonna go ahead and season this side too. party rub first. And we're going to go on with the heavy smoke white label. Typically, I'd use a binder, but since this was sitting in the brine all night and I just injected it, it's a little wet on the outside, so it'll be plenty good. And that is going to be good. The drum is still coming up to temp, so when we're throwing this on the grill, we will pick back up. All right, down at the gateway, or out at the gateway. I mean, we're recording in the garage, and the gateway's in the garage, because we're supposed to get a crap ton of rain this afternoon, and I really don't feel like getting my camera stuff wet, and more than that, I don't feel like getting my canopy set up. So out at the gateway, we're going to run this right on the left side of 300, so anything, as long as it doesn't get over 300, I'll be happy. As long as it doesn't get below 270, I'll be happy. We are going to use the, as you can see here, the meter plus to monitor the temp, so let's go ahead and get the bird on. I should go over my setup real quick. We got the rack down on the second peg, and then we got the bottom rack on as well with a pan full of water right in the middle. So yeah, go ahead and get the bird on. Smack dab right in the middle, just like that. Fits in there real nice. A little crooked on there, but you know, maybe the left side is jerky. I don't know. Anyways, we're going to close this thing down. We're going to run this where I said we're going to run it. And yeah, I'm expecting this bird, it's about... I think it's just about 15 pounds. I'm expecting this to be about a 3-hour cook. But then again, I thought the turkey halves would have been a lot longer than they took, and the drum just cooked them. So keep this thing closed down, and we'll pick back up in a little bit. All right, we've been on for about an hour and a half. Internal temp of the bird right now is at about 110. Let's go ahead and take a quick peek at it. Oh yeah, looking like a turkey. Not much else to do here except close this down. I could rotate it, but I think it's cooking just fine the way it is. So I'm going to go ahead and close this thing back down. And yeah, I'm guessing it's probably got about at least another hour to go yet. So we'll probably check back in one more time out of the grill here. So we'll see you then. We are back. This turkey's been on right just a little over 3 hours. Internal temp right now is at about 161. Go ahead, take a peek. Man. That turkey's got some really, really, really nice color. Oh, a little steam there. Looking pretty darn good. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this inside, and I'm going to let it rest right out on the countertop, probably for at least 30 minutes, and then we will be picking back up when it's time to eat. So we'll see you then. Alrighty, we are back, and it is time to eat. Real quick, let's go over everything we did in this cook. Started with a 14.5-pound turkey. We did a 20-hour brine using the Oak Ridge Barbecue Game Changer. We did that, like I said, in a 5-gallon pail, and we let it sit in the fridge overnight. We took it out, we injected the breasts with about two full syringe, or I think a syringe and a half per breast. And then we rubbed it down with the Heavy Smoke White Label and the Tailgater Barbecue Party Rub. Threw it on the gateway using Blues Hog Lump Charcoal on the middle rack, and on the bottom rack we had a water pan. So it, in a way, it was kind of indirect, and you know, that water pan puts a little extra moisture into that cook chamber. And then brought this up to an internal at 160, brought it upstairs, let it rest, and carried it over to like 163, and here we have it. So without further ado, I can tell you right now, this thing smells absolutely fantastic. Well, let's just go ahead and cut into this thing and see if it tastes as good as it smells. All right, so again, I'm no expert at cutting turkey, but I'm gonna go ahead and just try to separate the drum from the breast. Right off the bone. Not an expert, there's still quite a bit of meat there, but this will get me through the taste test. I want to move the turkey over to the side. What I'm going to do here is just take a little bit of this breast meat. Looking, you know, really nice color on that. That is as juicy as you can about imagine. But let's just go ahead and take some slices here and see how we do. I wonder what kind of blade this is. This is one of the Dalstrom Quantum Series blades. Real quick shout out to Darren over at Ask the Barbecue. He had a giveaway on his Instagram page a while back for this knife, and I got lucky and won the Instagram giveaway. So thank you, Darren. That looks absolutely fantastic. Let's just take a piece quick, give you a close up before we zoom in for the taste test. There's the breast. That is, oh taking in. Let's do a little taste test. All right, let's go ahead and give this nice little piece of turkey a try here. That was absolutely fantastic. You know, using, this is the first time I used a Game Changer. I do think I like the LC barbecue follow play better for, you know, when it comes to the brining and the injection, and the injecting and stuff. But that Game Changer, that Oak Ridge barbecue Game Changer, that is super good. Made that breast. God, I don't know if I've ever had a turkey this moist before. I'll tell you that right now. Just packed full of flavor. You know, and I was a little concerned at first that doing a full strength brine at 20 hours would be a little overpowering. I honestly think, like, if you go onto their webpage, they have a brine chart, and you can do it says you can do a full bird at full strength brine anywhere from like 12 to 48 hours. So it just leads me to question, what would happen if I would brine it for 48 hours? Which, probably gonna do one more turkey to do yet this year, so maybe that one I'll let brine for the full day. Anyways, this cook, absolutely super simple. You know, turkey is, you know, it's such a cheap meat. I think, you know, from the south of it's gonna be hard to find this year. So, you know, if you want, you know, your turkey for Thanksgiving, make sure you get out there and get them now. But I love turkey. You know, I probably don't love it all year round, but there's certain meats that I like around Thanksgiving, and obviously turkey's one of them. Turkey's the only one that's good, everything else I eat all year round. But you know, besides that, I got nothing else. Tailgater barbecue party rub on there, fantastic. That heavy smoke white label, I think that's what I was calling. But anyways, both of the rubs on there, absolutely fantastic. So besides that, I'm gonna stop stuttering over my words here. We're gonna go ahead and eat. Hope you guys and girls liked this video. If you did, shoot me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and I'm a kind of guy who likes to smoke meat, buy grills, and drink Busch Light. So besides that, see you next time.